In the context of data centers, let's first talk about internet services. An internet service is any type of service that's accessible via a web interface. From checking current weather conditions at weather.com, to searching or checking email via Google Search and mail services, to making online bank transactions or flight reservations. The common way in which these services are used is end users send web requests via web browsers and then receive a response. Most commonly, these types of services are decomposed into three components. A presentation component that interfaces with the end users. It's typically responsible for static content related to the web page layout. A business logic component. This is a component that integrates all of the business-specific processing. And this would be all of the dynamic user-specific content. And then a component that deals with all of the data storage and management, typically in a database. These components are commonly referred to as the presentation, the business, and the database tiers. Although these are separate components, they're not always implemented as separate processes running on separate machines. What makes sense will depend on the service complexity, the resource requirements, expected loads, and also on the underlying technologies that are used. For instance, the Apache HTTP web server can be used to implement both the presentation logic to serve static content and also as part of the same process, PHP modules for PHP processing can be used to generate the dynamic content. There are in fact many open source as well as proprietary solutions that are available that offer technologies for either one of these tiers. To put these applications using these kinds of tiers together, there are various integrative software or rather middleware components that are used that provide commonly used functionality, messaging services, service configuration and management, security, accounting, some persistence guarantees, recovery management, and many others. One important point to make is that for services that are organized as multiple processes, the inter-process communication among those processes is carried out via some form of IPC, such as RPC or RMI for Java-based architectures, as well as some use of optimizations that are based on shared memory in case the different processes are running on the same machine. So these are some of the examples of the inter-process communication mechanisms that we already discussed in this course, and these are relevant in the context of real-world deployments of internet services.